birth of our beautiful bombs takes place in a modern Dante's Inferno. In enormous furnaces gushing flame, metal is being melted under temperatures brought up to 1650 degrees centigrade. Pathé Gazette brings you exclusive pictures of one of our giant munition factories in full blast, turning out thousands of tons of high explosive cargoes for the RAF. As the furnace is tapped, a hissing stream of molten metal spurts into the casting ladle. A cascade of white-hot steel deftly manipulated through each successive stage of its early history. From the ladle, it's released into the molds for casting the billets out of which the bombs are forged. The red-hot block goes through a succession of annealing processes from now on. Every bomb casing is an achievement of engineering. Scaling removes an outer crust from the billet, which is then dropped through a trap to be cooled off rapidly. Here you see a bomb which has received further attention in the furnace, traveling to its next stage of production. An hydraulic press with a drive of 1,500 tons behind it noses into the metal as if it were clay. The steel squeezes under the pressure until the billet is twice its former length. After another annealing process, it goes through a succession of machining operations on the bomb production line. Ultimately, our great big beautiful bombs are subjected to a series of grooming processes by girl operatives and finally receive their initial coat of paint. They're about to come out of the works to give Hitler the works. There they are, things of beauty and a joy for every bomb rack. From the filling factories where they receive their meal of high explosive, they'll be taken over by RAF Maintenance Command. Some of these will take Hitler's breath away. Let's hope for good.